This is the logout page. You will see there are two variables, station variables, which I am making null. Null means I am making it empty. Since when user goes to the logout page, means I don't want user to remain in the station. So I make the two variables null, and then I call unset variable. Unset means delete the session. So I delete the session for that user. So user is not able to log in the page once he goes to the logout. He's logged out state. He's not in the session anymore. And I don't know him anymore. Now, what happened in the login? In the login, you will see the session variables are created here. One is called the username. One is called the user group. What is there in username? Email. What is there in user group? Access level. That is, if he is a member or admin. Level is needed. When I go to admin pages, I should be able to recognize that user is admin or not. Now, if you username the email, okay, but if you see our database table, all the table needs user id, right? Everywhere I need the user id. In the messages I need user id, in the records I need user id, in the everywhere I need user id to track the user. But when I am creating the session, I am only creating session with the email. This username is email, this username is email, but I am not doing anything with the user ID. So we will modify the Dreamweaver code to take the user ID also, because we need user ID on all the pages. We ultimately save the user ID, not the email, in all the tables. Email is only saved in the users table, but this user ID is saved in all the tables. So we modify Dreamweaver's code to save the user ID in the session. So how to modify? I will go into the login. I will go to the 22 number line. If you see, we are getting email, user password, access level from the database. I will add comma and I will add some phase which I want to save it in the session. So for example, if I want to save the user ID, I will say comma ID. Let's say I feel tomorrow, let's save the first name also of the username. So I will put first name. Let's say if I tomorrow say, let's add last name also in the session so that I don't need to go to database to get this information of the person who is logged in. Let's say I want to get the age of the person. So I will put age also. Let's say if I want gender also, I will put gender also. Now what I will do, like you see, this is the one code which will take the access level. See, this is taking the access level. I will copy this one code for multiple times. Each time I will put different variable. First name user ID, first name, last name, age. So I'm only copying this part multiple times to get all the information. Gender. So I got all the information. Now what I'll do, I will create a session for each of the information. Let's say today I don't want to use all the, I just want user ID because that is important. So let's do, make it simple and do it only user ID. So it will be easy. We can add more feature, but right now we don't need it. We need only user ID. I showed you to see how we can add more things. So now I will add one more part that is called the user ID. And here I will change, this is starting from MM. So I will give some similar name, say MM underscore user ID. So I created one user ID here. I created one line here. I added one line here. Three lines added in the login page. If I go to the logout, I will also copy this part. And here I will say MM user ID. And if I want to unset, I will copy this part. And I will also here say MM user ID. So whatever session I create in the login, I have to unset here in the logout page because I want to delete the session which I created in the login. So try to do these two pages. In the login, add one part here, add one part here, and add one part here. Three parts. Open your login. Line number 22, line number 29, and line number 33.